Well, for me, Adam Sandler called me. We're friends. We've been friends since 1991. And it's the way it always happens with me, because I've done a lot of his films. Like, Nealon, I got a part for you. I think you're going to like it. You're this guy on vacation in South Africa on the resort. You got a hot young wife. All right, I'll do it. You know, and then he sends the script over and I read it, and it just kind of solidifies that I want to do it, you know, by seeing the script. They're always funny, and there's always room for improv in it too, which is great. He's very loose about that.
This is my first film, so I had a lot of auditions for this part, and I got lucky. I think that the casting process is sort of like proving a scientific fact. You need infinite yeses or just one no. So that's why I say it's like a very lucky thing to be cast in anything. Because there just needs to be one person who's like, nah, we want a brunette or something like that. And so I'm the luckiest. I can't believe it. I really am the luckiest.
Yeah. Well, it's my second marriage, of course, and I have a 16-year-old son towing along with me, and we are genuinely in love with each other, and I think it's just a display. It's not only a public display, but it's a real display of affection, and capital A with A, affection, and I think we're really meant for each other, and it couldn't be a better place to vacation.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we really want to make it work. At first, it's a little bit over the top and it's obnoxious, but I think by the end, they're really endearing, and I think they really do just want to make their family blend, and they're going to end up together
and
forever.
They're having so much fun.
Yeah, you know, they're the funnest.
A lot of people don't know how to let go and have fun.
Yeah.
And these two are just, it doesn't matter where they are having fun, they're enjoying life, mm-hmm. and they're ready for it, and it's happening in this movie. Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, when you have a hotel that offers a blended package, you know, we're going to be first on board. We were still kind of jet-lagged because it's a long flight from Los Angeles to Africa. So it was a night shoot, and we were sitting around this table. I mean, it was very cold, too. I remember that. And it was just about all night, right, we were shooting at that table, and I had just met Jessica that day or the day before, and so we're just kind of getting to know each other, and everybody was kind of getting acclimated to the environment and to each other. So that was the first night that we shot, and it was fun, and Terry was doing his dance, and
I think we spoke a couple words to each other in the gym. That's the first place we met. And I think that's how Ginger and Eddie met, maybe.
Probably they did meet that way.
Yeah,
they
met in the gym. And then they, and then we spoke 7 more words to each other at the table. And then it was action, and we started making out. And then we didn't stop for 6 weeks.
It's like being at a nightclub.
Yeah, it was the longest nightclub.
Yeah, well, these films are well written. You know, they put a lot of work into it, but they're always open for new ideas, new jokes. And, you know, when you bring somebody in on a film, an actor that you know has background in comedy, you really want to hear what they have to offer. So Adam allows us to do a lot of that, improvising and experimenting. And that's where you get a lot of the gold, I think.
Yeah. Comedic writers can't be precious about lines, and so I think funniest always wins, and Adam really understands that, and so like he let us really play with the scripts as written and then go crazy with it.
Oh, Oh, yeah.
Yeah, when you, so Kevin in one scene, and it didn't make the final cut of the film, he spits purple juice onto my chest and then licks it off. Just the impact of the liquid right here like made me start laughing hysterically and I couldn't stop. And I was trying so hard not to ruin it, but that's why I didn't make the film probably. It's because I couldn't stop laughing. It was so disgusting.
He's passionate about what he does. He loves comedy. He knows that formula that works, and he's a hard worker. He's very dedicated to his profession.
Yeah, he's an expert at comedy at this point. And watching him work was like taking a master class.
He knows what works well for him.
Yeah,
you know, in comedy, he knows how much to push it and what he can get away with, and just what he knows his audience, I think. Yeah, they do. This is the third film together, and they've all been box office smashes, I think.
Yeah, they genuinely appreciate each other and they love each other, and I think that's what makes them work so well. Yeah, it really shows on screen that they really genuinely like each other. They have this bond that can't be broken, and I remember watching Wedding Singer was the first time I understood what chemistry was, because in my mind, this couple on screen were just married and in love, and they decided to make a movie together.
I mean, obviously, neither one of them are very bright, but the chemistry works fantastic. Frank doesn't bring anything.
Nothing.
He's a pain in the ass.
He's a meatball on sticks.
Yeah, he's just riding on Sandler's coattails because they went to college together. No, Coraci, he definitely adds that Coraci kind of a twist to the films. You know, The Wedding Singer and the other ones. But he's really easy to work with. You know, he's just like some directors. You feel you can't approach them, but with Frank, you go right up and you go, Frank, what do you think? And you know, he'll tell you what he thinks, and he laughs.
He does this look when you know you hit gold when he's like, yeah. He has like a crazy like twinkle in his eye, and he nods quickly in an upward motion.
Yeah.
That's when you know you nailed it with Coraci.
It was surreal. It was just, it's one of those places you know all your life, and you know about the animals and the safaris and, you know, all the turbulence they've had over the years and the beauty of the continent, and to actually get to go there was something that, you know, like for me, and you know, I mean, I've been around for a while and I've gone to a lot of places, but I've never been to South Africa, and that opportunity I was not going to let get by.
Yeah, when Drew in the movie says we're going to Africa, and then it's Africa, and you hear the music, and then it's all of these huge shots that are just gorgeous. Honestly, I've seen it 3 times. Every single time, it makes my heart pump more blood. I can't even take it. I love it so much.
And to go with all these fun people too is that was like a field trip.
You know?
It wasn't you're just going with your family and running into people, but you were there, and it was like a camp.
Yeah. Also, we had 200 or so South African extras in all those big dinner scenes, and they love Adam Sandler and Drew Barrymore, and they couldn't believe they were in an Adam Sandler, Drew Barrymore film, but they were also saying that they are so appreciative that they're doing like a really fun-loving comedy, like a romantic comedy that takes place in South Africa, and it's not another really sad movie that takes place in South Africa. It's not like a blood diamond. It's showing how great it is to go there.
And what a great time to be there too. I mean, we learned so much about the culture and the people, and Nelson Mandela at that period of time, he was on his deathbed and in the hospital, out of the hospital, President Obama came over and we saw Air Force One down in Cape Town. And you know, I mean, there was a lot going on at the time. We visited Mandela's cell in Robben Island, and really learned a lot about that country.